our sincerity, except Allah. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah, accept our ta'ah, and accept our time for his sake. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Welcome my brothers and sisters to another time, another Tuesday lecture, and alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed us with another time so we can meet together, insha'Allah rabbal alameen. May Allah bless us all, Allahumma ameen. And I just wanted to welcome all of you, welcome our Imam, Imam Hisham. And we are expecting, inshallah, to have our Imam, Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid. So, inshallah, we can start by the Quran recitation by Imam Hisham, Imam Masjid Al-Salam in Dunedin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykhana.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah. Inshallah, we start by the Quran recitation till we get our Imam. Then we can start with the introduction, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen.
Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khairan. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد نصركم الله ببدر وأنتم أذلة فاتقوا الله ولقد نصركم الله ببدر وأنتم أذلة فاتقوا الله فاتقوا الله لعلكم تشكرون إذ تقول للمؤمنين ألن يكفيكم أن يمدكم ربكم بثلاثة آلاف من الملائكة إذ تقول للمؤمنين ألن يكفيكم أن يمدكم ربكم بثلاثة آلاف من الملائكة منزلين بلى إن تصبروا وتتقوا ويأتوكم من فورهم هذا يمددكم ربكم يمددكم ربكم بخمسة آلاف من الملائكة مسومين وما جعله
الله إلا بشرى لكم ولتطمئن قلوبكم به وما النصر إلا من عند الله وما جعله الله إلا بشرى لكم ولتطمئن وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَكِيمِ ليقطع طرفا من الذين كفروا أو يكبتهم فينقلبوا خائبين ليس لك من الأمر شيء أو يتوب عليهم أو يعذبهم فإنهم ظالمون ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله غفور رحيم صدق الله العظيم
بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا our imam may Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless you and may Allah accept your recitation اللهم امين يا رب العالمين. Let me welcome also our Imam, Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid, Imam Masjid al-Rahman in Tarpon Spring. And may Allah give you shifa, Imam. Allahumma ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakum Allah khairan. My dear respected Imam Ahmad Ali and Imam Hisham, may Allah bless you.
Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allah khairan. And what a beautiful recitation that we have heard from our Imam, Imam Hisham. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory only comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, my brothers and sisters, we have this lecture tonight in a very critical and a very sensitive time, actually. And if you want, like the time that we try to come together so we can talk and we can learn something new about our religion. And as we talked about the invitation for the lecture tonight, it's about the power of the dua. And to be honest with you, actually, you find yourself speechless with that number of the brothers and sisters who are facing the troubles and the killing and tribulations and the difficulties. And subhanAllah, you find yourself wanted to make lots of du'as. Like if it is my decision, actually, I would make the entire lecture as du'a for our brothers and sisters. Because in this time, I don't actually try, I try to hold myself, to hold my tears, to hold my heart. I feel like my heart is shaking. I feel like we have a lot to talk about, but sometimes you find the situation or you find the scenes are even bigger than any talk, bigger than any speech, bigger than any lecture. But let's, as we came, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alameen, to the lecture, we talk about the power of the dua. And that's what Allah actually said in the Quran. Oh Muhammad, when my servants, when my slaves ask you about me, I am near to them. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am near to them. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. But it's not also about the dua. But we should ask ourselves, did we fulfill the conditions of the dua? And there is a powerful statement for Imam Hassan al-Basri. When people asked him, لِمَاذَا نَدْعُوا فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَنَا. Why, when we make a dua, Allah does not answer our dua? And he started to count 10 of the things. These are the reasons. And of course, the time will not be enough to mention all of the 10. But I wanted to tell you, if we wanted to talk about the dua, conditions of the dua, the status of the dua, we need to be sure, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. Make a dua to Allah while you are certain of the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I wanted to introduce our imams, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen, Imam Hisham, and also Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen, so we can learn from them today what we need to know about the dua. What are the conditions that we need to fulfill in our dua, insha'Allah. So I want to introduce Imam Hisham Salam, Imam Masjid As-Salam in Dunedin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him abundantly till we get back to our Imam Jalal, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen. Yes, our Imam.
Insha'Allah, jazakumullah khair, Imam Ahmed. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق وسيد المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو يتولى الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وإمامنا محمدا عبده ورسوله ولي المتقين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله ومن سار على هداه واتبع خطاه إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، all praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him, thank him, seek his help and forgiveness. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, as you mentioned, our Imam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, taught us and taught the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam to make dua all the time. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you know, it's a very great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he answers your dua. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم، وقال سبحانه واذا سالك عبادي عني فاني قريب اجيب دعوه الداع اذا دعان. سو الله تبارك وتعالى ان سوره أغافر said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And Allah تبارك وتعالى and your Lord said, make dua for me and I will answer your dua. He said also in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. When my servants ask you about me, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, tell them that I'm near Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala listens to your dua and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala answers your dua and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala always chooses the best for you for the Muslim ummah subhanallah ya rabbil alameen. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam encouraged his ummah to make dua all the time even if the answer is very late and you didn't receive your answer from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala but Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala one day will answer your dua. Allah only chooses the best for you. So let's talk about the best times of dua as we learn it from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and the sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ardahum learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The first time of making dua, one of the best times to make dua and to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is between adhan and iqama, when the muaddin finishes his adhan and waiting for the iqama, for the start of the salat, for about 5, 10, 15 minutes, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will answer your dua at this time. As he said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, الدُّعاءُ لا يُرَد. Dua is never rejected. Dua is never refused. بين الأذان والإقامة, between أذان and the إقامة. So when you finish your أذان and finish repeating the أذان after the مؤذن, try to pray two rak'ahs for Allah تبارك وتعالى and make your dua till the إقامة starts and the time of the salah starts. So the first time is between أذان and the إقامة. The second time is to make dua at night, starting from the middle of the night and before al-fajr prayer, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala taught us and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam taught us that our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the every night he descends subhanahu wa ta'ala to the lowest heaven when two-thirds of the night have passed and says subhanahu wa ta'ala, who supplicates me so that I answer his dua? Who supplicates me, who makes istighfar, who wants anything from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala so that I answer his dua. So if you make dua at that time, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ينزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى إلى سماء الدنيا كل ليلة حين يبقى ثلث الليل الأخير فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له, من يسألني فأعطيه, من يستغفرني فأغفر له, حتى ينفجر الفجر, أي حتى يأتي الفجر. The third time is to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and make dua while you are in your sujood. As he says, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد. The nearest position of the slave and the mu'min to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is in your sujood, is when he is making his sujood during his salah. So if you are praying salatu al-dhuhri, how many sajdas can you do or have you to do in Salatul Dhuhri? You have to do 8 sajdas. So when you make your sujood, ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala every time and he subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. Don't forget to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give you the ni'mah fi dunya, in the dunya. Don't forget to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to forgive your sins. Don't forget your ummah. Don't forget your brothers everywhere all over the world. And ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to protect them. Ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to help them and support them. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. And the fourth time is to make dua after each salah, after you finish your salah. Some scholars said that means after finishing your salah completely, which means after you say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, then start your dua or start your adhkar and then your dua. Others said that after you finish at tashahud, after you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, till you reach innaka hamidun majid, then start your dua. Whether you do that or this, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala inshallah will accept your dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, after he taught his companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum wa ardahum to make and say tashahud, he said sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, thumma liyakhtar min ad-du'ai أعجبه إليه فيدعو. Then every one of you should choose what he wants from the dua and the statements of dua and make dua and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will answer his dua inshallah rabbil alameen. Also on Friday, you know that it's a blessed day and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ordered us to make salah for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we know on Friday. And
especially the time between Asr and the Maghrib. After Salatul Asr till Salatul Maghrib, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala answers your dua at this time, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, you can make dua, one of the best times to make dua is when it's raining, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thintani ma turaddani, al-dua inda al-nidai wa tahta al-matar, which means that he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in two cases, in which if the slave and the abd and the mu'min makes dua and asks Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will not reject his dua. The first is when you or after you hear the azan, after you listen to the azan and repeat after the muaddin, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will accept your dua, as we said before. And the second case is when it's raining, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will accept your dua. The last one is when you or after you drink Zamzam water, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, ma wa zamzama lima shuriba lah. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the water of Zamzam is for whatever it's drunk for. So, brothers and sisters in Islam, I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to save our ummah, to protect our brothers all over the world, to protect our brothers in Palestine, and to protect our brothers everywhere, inshallah, rabbil alameen. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help them, to support them, and to give them the power to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and to be patient and face these calamities and face these tests from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wants, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us and his companions. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins and protect our ummah. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. Jazakum Allahu khayran Imam Ahmad, jazakum Allahu khayran Sheikh Jalal. جزاكم الله خيرا dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
جزاكم الله خيرا. And actually, it's very important to know the times of the du'a. One of the great things that actually we need to support our brothers and sisters during this time, that we need to make du'a in our salah. And it is called al-qunut 'inda an-nawazil, which is to make a dua on the time of the calamity, in the time of the tribulations, in the time of the hardship. And that's actually what we need to do. Even in jama'ah, every salah, you can make qunut. What does it mean? And at any salah, you pray. Even fard salah, the last ruku' or the last rak'ah, when you stand up from the ruku' and before you move to the sujood, you make a dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for your brothers and sisters, whether this dua was secretly or publicly, that is called dua ul qunut. And actually, it might have other ways of making them, like some people in other madhahib might make it right after the recitation of the Quran and before the ruku', so whether you choose to make it before the ruku' or after the ruku', it is sunnah from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make dua al-qunut. And I believe that this is the time for the dua of qunut, that is the least that we can provide for brothers and sisters in Islam. They got massacred just in the last 2 hours. Hundreds of people were killed in the hospital. At least 500 people, even more, in the last 2 hours. I think that is the least that we can do, is to make the dua. And when we say the least, we do not belittle the dua. It is the powerful tool that Allah had given us. And we will listen to our Imam Jalal to tell us how powerful is our dua would be. And we believe in Allah that this is a powerful tool that Allah had granted us. It's not something that we say, okay, make dua, as it is something unuseful or something will not support them. No, we will listen to our imam to understand that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, as he said, الدعاء هو العبادة. In another narration, الدعاء مخ العبادة. دعاء is the brain, like the brain to the body. Your brain to the body, that is the دعاء to our worship. And he said, it is the essence, the core of our worship to Allah is our دعاء. Yes, our Imam, I give back to you. I think you had interruption maybe in the line, but really, actually, I make a dua for our Imam, Imam Jalal. May Allah grant you shifa and speed recovery. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen.
Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear respected brothers and sisters, a'udhu billahi as-sami' al-alim min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد, my dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear respected brother Sheikh Ahmed Ali, may Allah bless you, Ameen Ya Rabbil Ameen, dear respected Imam brother Hisham, may Allah bless you and your family, Ameen Ya Rabbil Ameen. Welcome back, my dear respected brothers and sisters, in Tuesday. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Ameen for this beautiful gathering. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to gather us together with the Prophet of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the highest level of Jannah, in Jannah al-Firdaus. Ameen Rabbil Ameen. Yes, it is looking to be sad days, subhanallah al-azim, because all those souls that been killed today. But one of the beautiful things that we prove, alhamdulillah Rabbil Ameen, that the Quran is real. The Quran is reality. The Quran is touch in our daily base. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. That's why Imam Ahmed and Imam Hisham and me, we choose the dua, the power of the dua, the powerful of the dua. And I'm going to talk about just one of the prophets, the prophets, Prophet Nuh, when he called Allah Azza wa Jalla. Just to give you an example, my dear respected brothers and sisters, about the power of the dua. Because you call who? You call Allah Azza wa Jalla. You call the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You call the one who is strong and he can. Is my voice is okay, my Sheikh Ahmed? Alhamdulillah. Because the internet is acting, I don't know why. So alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, the powerful and the power of the dua. Prophet Nuh, peace and blessing be upon him, alayhi salatu wasalam, he called Allah azza wa jal in a shortest dua, very short. It's even one ayah and very very short ayah. What he said, he supplicated to Allah azza wa jal and he said, rabbi inni maghlubun fantasir. That's it. My Lord, I'm getting defeated. Fantasir, help me, give me the victory. That's it. That is it. So what happened? What did the response from Allah Azza wa Jal? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as our brother Sheikh Hisham and Sheikh Ahmed, may Allah bless both of them, Ameen Ya Rabbil Ameen, when Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي, when my servants asking you about me, asking you as Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, about me, فَإِنِّي قَرِيب, I am here, I'm nearby, أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي, I respond to the call, I answer the call of the da'i, of the one who supplicates, you know, makes supplication to me. So Prophet Nuh, he said this very small supplication to Allah Azza wa Jal. I always ask myself, wallahi, my dear respected brothers and sisters, because the response from Allah Azza wa Jal upon Prophet Nuh, it is unbelievable. It is unbelievable. What happened with Prophet Nuh, especially with the Prophet Nuh, you know, there is no one all over the world ask Allah Azza wa Jal, same like Prophet Nuh, at this is short, and the response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal changed the whole world for Nuh. Changed the whole world. Changed the sunnah of Allah Azza wa Jal. What is the meaning of the sunnah of Allah for al-kawn, for this world? We know that there is a sun and there is a moon. We know that there is a day and there is a night. You know, they will not change. We know that there is rivers. We know that there's trees. There is, gardens. We know a world. That's what we know. Subhanallah al-Azim. But Allah Azza wa Jal changed all those only for the sake of da'wah,
of one supplication, small supplication. Prophet Nuh did it when he asked Allah Azza wa Jal this, you know, supplication. So Allah Azza wa Jal said, respond, and he said, فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ. You know, so Allah Azza wa Jal said, we open the gates of the heavens. You know, أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ. So it's not just a rain. It's not any like usual rain that we saw it, even it's heavy rain or no, أبواب, the gates of the heavens. بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ. You know, it's continuous, very, very harsh. You know, there is a lot of pressure, you know, with this water. Subhanallah al-Azim. وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عُيُونًا. And Allah Azza wa Jal also spoke about the whole earth, al-Ard, not from al-Ard or not from like specific. We know, my dear respected brothers and sisters, if hurricane came, for example, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect you. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. You know, the hurricane, it will not come to all America, only in specific parts. You know, when the earthquake come, for example, to Morocco or come to Turkey, so it comes to a specific part of the world. It doesn't come to the whole world at all, you know, all together. But Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضِ. You know, the earth itself and became springs of the water. So the water come from the heavens and the water come from the earth, and both of them, they touch each other. فَالْتَقَى الْمَاءُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ الْعَظِيمُ. With the taqdeer of Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, with the measurement. So there is no night, no day, no night, no sun, no moon, nothing. No even air, nothing at all except for water. Water everywhere. All this is for the power of the dua. What kind of heart of Prophet Noah? Allah, I always ask myself this question. Prophet Noah, at this small supplication, and Allah Azza wa Jal changed the whole world to him. The whole world, subhanallah al-azim, for him. So it's not, wallahi, why? Because we ask the generosity of Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear respected brothers and sisters, as our Prophet, our Imam Ahmad, he said, you know, the dua is not the least. The least we can say, the least we can do, you know, because this is our turn to make the dua, and Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who able to do everything. Why? Because we ask the power of Allah Azza wa Jal, which is one of his attributes, that he is al-qawi, he is the strong, meaning there is no one even can defeat or can be able to be just near him like al-aziz, subhanallah al-azim. So al-ghani, Allah Azza wa Jal, so when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We did not ask anyone, we did ask no one, and because this is what we can do, this is our turn. It's just to make dua at this day. How many people they lost their life? How many people they get killed? You see yourself, you know, we did not talk about something. It's not there. We talk about something. It's in the TV and you can see it like, subhanallah, day and night. So when you see all those people lost their life, we have nothing to do except for ask Allah Azza wa Jal to clear it and to make it and to accept the shahada. Inshallah, Rabb al-Alameen. And inshallah, I'm sure that Imam Hisham and Imam Ahmad, inshallah, Rabb al-Alameen, Imam Hisham, when he do the supplication, it's going to be like for all of those people, including all Muslims, Ummah, inshallah, Rabb al-Alameen. May Allah bless you, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And this is proof that the Quran is the life and the Quran is touching our daily basis, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. The Quran is not like 5,000 years ago and for the old fashion, like they said, no, the Quran is there. And here is the proof, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. The Quran is touched the reality today and tomorrow and inshallah until the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your good deed, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Again, thank you, brother Imam Ahmad Ali and Imam Hisham. May Allah bless you, and back to you, Imam Ahmad, inshallah.
I think this is the time that we can go for the dua with our Imam Hisham. May Allah accept his dua. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Yes, our Imam, please. We wanted the dua for all the brothers and sisters, inshallah.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم لك الحمد حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في كل مكان وانصر إخواننا المجاهدين في فلسطين اللهم كن لهم عونا ونصيرا ومؤيدا وظهيرا انصرهم على أعدائهم يا رب العالمين اللهم احقن دماءهم الطاهرة يا رب العالمين اللهم فك أسر من أسر منهم يا رب العالمين اللهم تقبل من استشهد منهم يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم ارفع درجات شهدائهم في عليين وتقبل شهداءهم يا رب العالمين اللهم أقر عيوننا برفع رايتهم يا رب العالمين اللهم أقر عيوننا برفع رايتهم يا رب العالمين اللهم أرنا في أعدائهم آية يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم منزل الكتاب اللهم هازم الأحزاب اهزم من تجمعوا على إخواننا من المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في فلسطين اللهم كما أنزلت على أهل بدر ملائكتك أنزل عليهم جندك يعينهم يا رب العالمين أرنا آية في أعدائهم يا قوي يا متين اللهم عليك باليهود والمشركين وكل من آذى المسلمين اللهم رمل نساءهم كما رملوا نساء المسلمين اللهم يتم أطفالهم كما يتم أطفال المسلمين اللهم احقن دماء إخواننا في فلسطين يا رب العالمين كن لهم نعم المولى ونعم النصير يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم اشف صدور المؤمنين بنصر إخوانهم المؤمنين اللهم اشف صدور المؤمنين بنصر إخوانهم المؤمنين اللهم لا ترفع لليهود في فلسطين راية اللهم أرنا فيهم آية واجعلهم عبرة لأولي الأبصار يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم استجب من أمة حبيبك الدعاء وارفع عن أمة نبيك البلاء
برحمتك وقدرتك يا رب الأرض والسماء. اللهم قد دمعت عيوننا مما نراه من قتل أبنائنا، فأقر عيوننا بنصرهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل راية الإسلام عالية خفاقة إلى يوم الدين. انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين، وأعلي بفضلك يا ربنا كلمة الحق والدين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
بارك الله فيكم شيخنا، جزاكم الله خيرا. من الله قصدت يا دعاء، اللهم أمين. جزاكم الله خيرا our Imam, Imam Jalan. جزاكم الله خيرا my brothers and sisters for participating. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.